Let us see today how to measure length by different instruments. Now this is a common meter scale. Although its length is not 1 meter, but as there are centimeters on the upper side of this scale, and therefore we can say it as a meter scale. Meter scale has 100 centimeters, that means 1 meter. Now the lower scale is also given there, and that is inch scale basically. So we are not dealing with the lower scale, we are dealing with the upper scale. And as I have told you that the width of the nail is equivalent to 1 centimeter, so you can recognize it very easily that this is 1 centimeter. Now what is the least count? Least count in the sense minimum countable measure. So what is minimum length we can measure with this scale, that we can see here. See, there are 10 divisions in a centimeter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the middle one is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. That means there are 10 divisions in a centimeter, and therefore we can divide 1 centimeter divided by 10. That means 0.1 centimeter, and that is the least count of this scale. You cannot measure less than 0.1 centimeter with the help of this scale. So there are limitations that you have to measure beyond 1 mm or 0.1 centimeter from this scale. Let us see now how to measure the length using vernier calipers. We have this another instrument to measure a lower side than 0.1 mm also, because the meter scale has its limitation, and that was it cannot measure beyond 0.1 centimeter or less than 0.1 centimeter. But this device called as vernier calipers is able to measure the even lower side of this 0.1 centimeter. Now this device has two inside jaws and two outside jaws. So if you want to measure a particular diameter or dimension of a certain material or body, you can measure. So this will measure the outer diameter of this cylinder, but these jaws cannot measure the outside diameter. But if you want to measure the inner diameter of certain things, suppose this hole, then I can put this into this hole and I can measure the inner diameter of this particular object. Okay, so for that these two jaws are available on this particular instrument. Now see, the lower scale you can see the meter scale as it is centimeter scale, upper we are not dealing as it is inch scale, and at the same time you can have these divisions on this movable jaw called as vernier scale. They are 10 lines. You can measure from this point to this point, they are 10. Now to find out the least count of this particular instrument, what you have to do, you have to note down first relation, that what is my MSD, that means one main scale division like this from this to this, or if I go here 0 to 1, what is the length. So again I will divide 1 centimeter by 10 divisions on this main scale, so I will get 0.1 centimeter as its least count of the main scale of the vernier caliper. So if you want to measure the least count, we have to compare vernier scale with main scale so as to get vernier scale division. Now I will close the jaws completely so that 0th line of this vernier scale is exactly matching with the 0th line of the main scale, and then I will count how many divisions are equivalent with the 10 divisions of the VS, and that means vernier scale. So you can see here the 9 ninth division on the main scale is matching with the 10th division of the vernier scale. So my relation will be 9 MSD equals to 10 VSD, and from that I can very easily calculate the 1 VSD, and 1 VSD can be calculated as 9 by 10 MSDs. So it will be equivalent to 0.9 MLD. Now MLD is 0.1, so 0.9 multiplied by 0.1 will be 0.09. So 1 VLD will be 0.09, and therefore I can have least count of this instrument as 1 MLD minus 1 VLD. So it will be 0.1 centimeter minus 0.09 centimeter, and I will get 0.01 centimeter as a least count of these vernier calipers.
Well, friends, wherever vernier caliper fails to measure the distance or diameter of any object, then we use this screw gauge so as to have reading with more accuracy. Now, in vernier calipers, you must have seen that the vernier scale moves forward or backward in a linear manner. That means only we have to apply a force in forward direction or reverse direction, just like this. I'm taking it in backward direction or pushing it in forward direction. But here in screw gauge, what is the difference between the two? Major difference here, you can see there is a main scale and there is this scale, but this is called a circular scale, because when we rotate this, then you can see what is happening. The screw is coming out and the distance between these two ends is closing up. So this is how the screw gauge works. Now this screw gauge has got main scale, as you can see it is a ordinary centimeter scale, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is millimeter up to 10 millimeter, that is 1 centimeter. And on the circular scale, as you can see, now right now I have adjusted it for 0. I go on changing it 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and 0. That means there are 100 divisions on this circular scale, and therefore the least count of this screw gauge is to be determined as the moment of this screw in one rotation divided by total number of division on the circular scale. Now this moment of the screw, as you can see, in one rotation, in order to denote that, it is called as pitch of screw. That means in one circular rotation, how much is the change in the position of that screw. Now I will demonstrate here. This is 0 of circular scale coinciding with the 0 of main scale, and now I open it through one rotation. So on completion of this one rotation, as you can see that the first division of the main scale is visible. That means in one rotation the screw, this screw has moved through 1 millimeter or 0.1 centimeter. That is the pitch of screw. And when this pitch of screw is divided by total number of division on circular scale, we get the least count of this screw gauge. And for measurement purpose, whatever is the object, we are required to hold it between this screw like this, and then we have to record the readings. So in short, this is about the least count of the screw gauge.
Let us see how to take measurements with these three instruments. The first instrument is meter scale, and second instrument will be vernier calipers, and the third instrument will be screw gauge. So we shall compare the observations taken by these three different instruments in a single experiment. I have one solid cylinder. I want to measure the diameter of this cylinder using all these three scales. Let us see now. I am taking this over here either, and it is seen that it is less than 5 mm or 0.5 centimeter, but a bit higher than 4 mm or 0.4 centimeter. You can see here, this is 0.5, and the other edge of this cylinder is coming earlier to that particular 0.5. So for a rough measurement, I should take 4 mm as a whole, because those are completed and 5 yet to complete, and that's why I will take my MSR, that means main scale observation, as 0.4 centimeter. This is centimeter. I will again take another observation having some different angle. Also, I will get the same observation, that is 0.4. And also, if I take this kind of observation, I will get 0.4, even 0.3. Sometimes I am getting 0.4 is completed. So 0.4 are my two more observations. So I will write 0.4 centimeter as a observation taken by the meter scale. So observation with meter scale, MS means meter scale, and I am measuring diameter of a cylinder. So I am writing here. Now I will firstly take observation with all these three instruments, and then we will see how to calculate the observation, exact observation, by other two scales. So I have completed the observation set by using a meter scale. Now I will go for more finer instrument, that is vernier calipers. So I will check whether my vernier caliper is okay. When the jaws are closed, I must get the zero of the MS, that means main scale, is exactly matching with the zero of the vernier scale. So vernier scale have 10 divisions, as you are aware of it, and if this is the situation, and 9 divisions on MS are matching with the 10 division of the vernier scale, then its least count will be 0.01 centimeter, or you can say 0.1 millimeter. So I will take observation. Again, I want to measure the diameter of this cylinder. I will see whether it is showing some observation over here, and I am getting it here, say just above, or rather exactly 0.5 centimeter. You can see 0.5 centimeter is the value measured by this instrument, but it is little earlier to 0.5. sometimes it comes earlier to 0.5. this is 0.5 line, and my zero of the vernier scale is not exactly matching with the 0.5, but it is coming just earlier to that. Therefore my observation should be 0.4. so for vernier calipers, it should be 0.4 as a MSR. And now I wanted to see what divisions is matching with exactly with the divisions of MS, that means main scale. Okay, so my vernier caliper is giving me 0.4 as a MSR, and around 7 or 8 line of the VSD is matching with the MLD. That means either 0.8 division or 9 division I can write over here. Okay, so this is first observation by the vernier caliper. Again I will shift this position and see whether I will get some different observation over here. Again the MS is showing 0.4, and the VS is showing 0.9, sorry, 9th division. See, these two divisions are exactly matching. So I can write 0.4 and here 9 division. Similarly, again I will get this kind of observations 8. And now the observations by vernier calipers is over. So I will replace the instrument now and I will see whether my screw gauge is 0 corrected or not. So it is 0 corrected. You can see this 0 line is matching with the horizontal line, that is reference line, on the main scale. So my screw gauge is 0 calibrated. Now I will take this particular cylinder to measure its diameter again. Same cylinder I am here using, and see the value I am getting here, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 and 0.4, and around 96 divisions. So in the measurements with screw gauge, I am writing here MSR is 0.4 centimeter and CLD. Here the circular scale divisions we have to measure, and circular scale division is matching here. See, this is 90, this is 95, and I will just magnify it, and this is 96, or this is 95, 96. So 96 divisions are matching with this particular CLD with MLD or reference line. Now again I will shift the position a bit and again measure the similar observation. Here also I am getting again 0.4 as MSR and 97 divisions are CLD, 0.4, 97 division. So how I have to take the observation? I have to take this particular screw and I have to move it clockwise till it start clicking sound or something like this. Okay, so the pressure I am giving on this particular object is same in all observation. If I move this particular thing, then it may change. See, I will show you how it changes. See, if I do it, it is showing only 96 or 97, but if I move this particular thing, then it may give some different erroneous observation and your observations are now faulty. So therefore, to have a equal pressure, we should use this particular screw. So it is a pressure, the pressure is same in all observation, in particular this particular screw. Okay, so I have completed the set of observation to measure a diameter of a given object or a cylinder, you can say. Now I have this many observation. Again in the third observation I am getting 96. So I will calculate the exact observation now. So go to first MS, that means meter scale. So total is 0.4, here again 0.4, and here again 0.4. So reading in centimeter, so you can say this is 0.4 centimeter. If you take mean, so mean means what? All the addition of all the observation divided by number of observations. 0.4 plus 0.4 plus 0.4 divided by 3, so you will get the reading as, or output as, 0.4 centimeters. So this is the measured value with the meter scale. So the value of diameter with the help of meter scale has been given as 0.4 centimeter. So this is what the observation. Now we can have another calculations. As we have seen in the earlier lecture or video, that the least count of a vernier calipers is how much? 0.01 centimeters. This is the least count. Okay, so we have to use this least count to calculate the exact observation. Now in this case I have got the VSDs as 8, so you have to multiply this 8 with least count, so you will be getting the first VSR, that means vernier scale observation or reading, as 0.08. now this is in centimeter because we are multiplying with this as a centimeter. Again in this case we will get 0.09 centimeter, and in the last you will get 0.08 centimeters. Okay, so these three observations I got, so I can take the TR as MSR plus VSR, that is TR, total reading is this plus this, because this is in addition. So initially TR will be 0.4 plus VSR is 0.08. That gives out the observation or total reading as 0.48 centimeters. Okay, so 0.48. In another observation, I will get 0.49. In another observation, I will get 0.48 again. So roughly I can take these and these as equal, so I can take the mean as we have calculated in earlier case as 0.48 centimeters. So this is the observation I have received with the help of vernier caliper. See, you can have the value 0.4 in case of meter scale, and now 0.48 in case of vernier calipers. Similarly, I have another observation or set of observation, and as you are aware that the least count of the screw gauge is 0.001 centimeters, so I will have to use this particular value over here. Now if I will take CSR for the first observation, where CSDs are 96, I will take 96 multiplied by 0.001, so I will be getting it 0.096 centimeters. Similarly here 0.097 and here 0.096. so these are all in centimeters, so total reading again will be this plus this, so I will be getting total reading in first observation 0.496, second 0.497, and in third 0.496. again here you can get these two as same observation, so I can take mean as 0.496 centimeters. Now see, this is the observation I have received by measuring it using screw gauge. Now if I compare this in the first set of observation taken by meter scale, the significant figure was only one, that is the observation is 0.4 centimeter. So beyond 0.4 I do not have any information by using meter scale, but in vernier scale I went one digit ahead, that is now significant figure is 2 now here, first and second. So I got the idea of the exact value by using vernier caliper, vernier calipers as 0.48 centimeter. And again if I go and more resolved result I got using screw gauge, that is 0.496. so I will trust this observation because there are significant figure is 3 now. In earlier case it was 2 and 1. So therefore this is most trustable value, and this way we conclude the experiment.